Welcome once again to Christ Clarity. Familiar territory, very simple territory. No problem here. And as you listen to this, these videos, don't worry if you can't remember some quotation from somewhere, because you don't need that. It's simpler than that. It may come up that you want to remember something, the Course in Miracles, there's some quote in there. I want to bring that up. Don't need to. Or some quote from Scripture. Or you want to remember, what was that sutra, you know? I can't quite remember it. That's okay. It's simpler than that. Because the basic facts are very simple. The more you dwell on the basic facts, the closer you get. That's why it's so important to work to make it simple. Quite simply, again, we are spirit. That's what we are. Extension of God, the Prime Creator. Our functionality given to us by the Prime Creator is to choose ideas and experience ideas and flow through this rich tapestry of ideas, infinite ideas, not bound by any idea at any particular moment, free, completely free to swim as we want to through this ocean of ideas. That's what we are. That's our functionality. Very simple. And at some point we chose one silly, very silly idea. The idea of replacing reality with a new reality. And this idea is so silly that it tricks us into fixating upon it. It's a tricky idea. The idea is a trickster. And we fixate upon it. Spirit fixates upon it. And what we're doing here is to loosen that fixation. And we do that by pointing out the basics, that we chose this idea. That's what we did. We chose the idea. How do we move on, keep swimming? We choose a new idea. And we feel incompetent right now because we're fixated on this one idea to the exclusion of all other ideas. So that's where this feeling of, we want to impress. Maybe we'll feel, if I can just remember that quote, that will be impressive. I'll feel more competent. Forget about it. Won't work. The only thing that works is resuming our full capacity, functionality of choosing ideas. Then we'll feel, we're doing what is natural, what is right. We feel completely competent at that point, but not until. So, you can relax. You don't need to access your memory as far as spiritual teachings go. You don't need to think back like, what was that spiritual teaching that I had a couple years ago? I had this insight or something. Now, that's okay for then. You don't need to bring that up. You can relax even more. Pay even more attention to the basics. So ultimately, that's where your success will come from. You don't need to remember, what was that teacher telling me? Non-dual, I am not this or that, and the consciousness, and I'm a witness of that, and forget it. It's okay. If I remember it, it's okay. If I don't, it's okay. Don't struggle with it. Don't try. Don't fixate on remembering spiritual teaching, because that too keeps your fixation on this idea. Don't fixate. Even don't fixate on this. be alert, be calm, be unfixated on it. Pay attention, but not that fixation. Like, I have to remember this, you know. I've got to remember it. I've got to store this away. I've got to bury this nut somewhere so that later on I can find it again. No, every one of these videos has the full story in it, because the full story is so simple. You don't need to recall and remember everything. Forget it. Just pay attention to the basics. And that, you'll know it's loosening you up, easing the pressure on you. You're starting to realize it's a safe thing to choose a new idea. You won't be annihilated. That's just another, that's part of the silly idea. Such a silly idea, it even claims that if you choose another idea, you'll be annihilated. Utterly foolish. You're seeing the complete, utter foolishness of the dance of this idea. Complete nonsense. And all you need to respond is simply, maybe you just have a slight chuckle. That's funny. That is so ridiculous. It's funny. Don't have to tell jokes. You don't need to be cajoled into truth by a storytelling jokester, you know. That, no need for that. You don't have to force anything. You can't be cajoled into truth, really. You can't be. You have to see it. You have to clarify it for yourself. You have to see it. You have to see that it's safe. You have to see, where does the threat come from? It comes from the silly idea. That's all. Threat comes from there. It's all made up. It's all ridiculous. Falsities. Falsifying. Nonsense. All comes from the idea of wanting to replace reality with a new reality. Completely impossible idea to experience. Total futility. And yet this idea is bragging and boasting and threatening and all this bluff. It's 100% bluff. And bit by bit by bit, you see that. You see this little bluff and this one and this one. It's all a bluff. And so what do you need to do about a bluff? Just see that it is a bluff, that's all. You don't need to counter the bluff with pull a quote from scripture out somewhere and say, you know, yeah, but da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. How about that? Take that, bluffer, you know. That's still trying to play the game. That's still a trap. Because you're still fearful. You think, maybe this bluffer has some power. I have to diminish their power a little bit. So let me lay some scripture on them and see how they react to that. Like we're zapping their power or something. Don't need to do that at all. It's 100% bluff. Completely untrue. That somehow reality has been damaged or changed or altered in any tiny way. It has not. Not even in the tiniest, smallest, subtlest, inconspicuous way has reality been changed or altered at all. Zero. You don't need to impress the bluffer. You know what? Because they're not going to be impressed. They'll pretend to be impressed, and then it'll suck you into doing more. And you throw more scripture at it, and more scripture, and it'll keep pretending to be impressed, but it is never impressed because it's dynamic. It comes from an idea. And it has to function this way. It has to bluff. So don't get caught up in that trap of thinking that you're putting it down because it pretends that you're being successful in putting it down, but you're really not. Just don't pay any attention to it. Dismiss it. Like a little gnat that's buzzing around. You just don't even pay any attention to it. It's all bluff. Just see that. See the bluff. Gradually the fear gets less and less and less. And it goes like that, day after day. You do the work. results show up. Okay, very good. That's it.